So, welcome, friends, to SDG Talks. Tobacco kills over 8 million people every year worldwide. Each tobacco-related deadly disease is preventable and death could have been averted if science and evidence-based tobacco control policies were strictly enforced and tobacco industry held liable. End tobacco is imperative for SDGs. Every year, the UN Health Agency, the WHO, World Health Organization Director General, confers a special award on World No Tobacco Day to recognize stellar contribution of those who are advancing tobacco control in different parts of the world. We at CNS were honored to receive this WHO award in 2005 and 2008. Today, it is a great honor for us to have this year's WHO Director General's World No Tobacco Day awardee amongst us. It is no other than National Statistical Office of Thailand, or TNSO's Director General, Madam Pianuch Vuthisorn. She is amongst us. Welcome, Madam, and super congratulations from all of us for helping save lives.
Thank you very much for your kind words. And for this award, it's a real prestigious award for not only for myself, for the whole organization and my team, and also other stakeholders outside as well. I would say, as Director General of the NSO, I'm grateful for receiving this esteem award. And this really meaningful for us, really make us motivated towards a better life of the people as the end product. Thank you very much for your kind word in for us in receiving this award from the WHO.
Yes. Thank you, ma'am. Can you please help us explain the role of a survey in advancing tobacco control?
Yeah, actually, the role of NSO in general, we do data producing in general. That means we do survey, we do census. This is in general. And for this, in terms of the survey on smoking behavior, we have done under the big survey, namely health behavior survey. Inside this survey, not just only smoking behavior, we look at alcohol intake behavior and also other the health diseases and other activity that may be harm or make thing adverse impact for health as well. And from here, perhaps I can let you know a little bit what in this survey, we look at, of course, smoking behavior in one section. And of course, in there, we have included the number of smokers, types and quantity of cigarette consumed that include the electric cigarette as well. This is just newly included based on the dynamism of the smoking context. And we look at expenditure on cigarette purchase, and we look at the desegregation in terms of areas. In Thailand, we have a so-called Changwat provincial area, and also sex, and we divide it in terms of different group of age, and we ask for awareness for any knowledge according to tobacco control laws and other behavior that may have adverse impact for smoking. And this is in general, to let you know.
Thank you, madam. So, madam, what is the impact of this survey data that affect change in Thailand?
Yes, this is very important because a lot of policy making body, especially tobacco control committee, use data and information from us. For example, information on awareness, this is very important, especially I make it clear, it's for example, the prohibition of selling tobacco products to individuals that age under 20 years old. This is whether or not they have known about this. And if we have seen the data that this knowledge, this awareness has not yet been known nationwide, and we should have more advocate activity on that, because we can see that people may breach the law as well if they don't know. This is for the lie of the work of the survey. For another thing, it's about the awareness as well. It's about whether or not they know the prohibition of marketing of cigarette is banned, either on site, either online. And this work is very important, because to use for utilization to support the monitoring and evaluation of the compliance under the law, the Tobacco Control Law 2017, this is very important. If in the case still not yet fully aware about this information, that's got to have other measure and activity in place. Yes, I would let you know as well. For example, the information from a survey, because we have the areas in terms of provincial area as well, we can know that in specific provinces, which regions or which province that have the high problem in terms of smoking situation, so that we can tailor the measure and also the activities targeted to the specific area. This is information. And at the same time, normally we need to prevent the new smoker, new age, especially for the teenager. We don't want them to involve in the smoking and adverse impact, so that if we have seen the situation, got to have stricter measure or policy to control as well. And this is the role of the survey. We do have other information and findings from the survey as well, especially expenditure on this particular item. And even we might need to impose taxation, increase tax in whatever form. And we've got to monitor whether or not our policy and measure that we have posed into the smoking context, whether or not it is effective and efficient, so that for policy making body, they use this kind of data survey from National Statistical Office.
Thank you so much, Madam Pianuj, for helping us understand this. And I'm so impressed and inspired to hear of the role which National Statistical Office of Thailand and you all have played in advancing tobacco control. So can you also enlighten us, what are the challenges in preparing statistical data for tobacco control?
Yes, Bobby, this kind of data for stakeholders involved in this area, they really have had high demand and high requirement. They wanted data in terms of disaggregation as well. Of course, we are now can do at just the level of provinces as representation at the provincial level only. And they may have want to make it at the lower level, because if you know the division of area in Thailand, from province, we go to district and have the level under district as well. We don't have this kind of data survey to represent. And from that, they require a wide range of information and data. They normally would like us to post more questions in questionnaire to get more information that that may be valuable for them in making a policy and also measure. But it's very difficult to ask people because right now we're facing with people kind of fatigue with giving information to the government. Yeah, they, and at the same time, the problem of urbanization as well. People tend to deny to answer a questionnaire from the governmental agency. And at the same time, at the urbanized area, it's really hard to get them. And so that this is all about the way of to obtain data is pretty much more difficult. And especially the kind of PDPA as well. People concerned about information about like a personal data, so that they tend to not give information in whatever the governmental agency go to ask them. And yes, I think this point, I would say this is the main problem, and we cannot drill down to the under level or provincial level. Because in theory, the more aggregated, of course, it's better to gain data for making policies, because we can get precise and concise information from such aggregated level.
Thank you so much again, Madam. Despite these challenges, you people have been able to advance such important work. And I hope it inspires other statistical offices in other countries worldwide. So, so Madam, can you also help us share success factors of tobacco control?
But I understand that success factor would be the same even at the global level as well. That is the cooperation among key stakeholders. This is very important, especially in the area of tobacco control, to exchange and sharing information, especially both success and failure of their policy and measure that has been conducted in other countries worldwide. And this is to learn from each other how to better control in tobacco. And I think participation, especially at the national level, upgraded to the regional level, or even at the international level. And the role of international agency as well has helped guide the way and the course of tobacco control. I would say that the cooperation, the participation amongst stakeholders at different levels, from national, regional, and also international, would be the key success factor in working in this area.
Thank you, ma'am. And before we conclude, we would like to hear what are the important issues which Thai NSO will like to raise or get see it raised at the upcoming Conference of the Parties of Framework Convention on Tobacco Control?
Yes, of course. Thailand NSO, we saw ourselves as a part of the people to work in the area of tobacco control. And we will continue to do this survey because we understand well that this information has been fully utilized and to be made to policy level and also at the implementation level as well. And from us and from outside, if we would say that positive impact of Thailand tobacco control is pretty much gaining a better situation. However, we still need to address specific problems that we saw from information that NSO provided. For example, the younger age still consume and kind of smoke quite a lot. And this is, we would like to address to international arena as well. And we would like to learn from others what would be efficient policy and also measure to help work to reduce smoking in teenager. I think at the age about 15 to 17, still concerned on this as well. Even we have the situation of smoking in terms of macro figure quite well, less than 20%. But when we look at the gender, male still a lot. The percentage of the smoking rate, I understand that more than 30%. And when for female, it's less and less and still have some percentage. But when we make it to national data, it come to less than 20. And this might be said that it's good, but it's not yet good enough. We still need to do more and to make the advocacy in this area to have a better situation, make people quit from tobacco. And at the same time, not just only look at particular smoking situation, we got to look at other issue related as well, because in tobacco industry, we got to see the supply chain, especially in the area of farmers, how to help them to get quit from crop to cultivate tobacco. I think this is a big issue, how to work with them besides the smoking rate, as I mentioned.
Thank you so much, Madam Pianuj. We are real learning for us to listen to you. Let us hope your words come true. Young people do not begin tobacco use. Those who are using tobacco are able to quit. Farmers of tobacco who are growing tobacco, they stop growing tobacco and are successfully transitioned to other crops and industry held liable. Thanks a lot. Let us hope all power to you. We wish you the best, and we really hope that your work of Thai NSO under your leadership as Director General will pave way, will be an inspiration, and will be a pathway for other countries to follow. Thanks a lot. All the best. And hope to see you at some point. Thank you. Goodbye.
Oh, bye-bye. Yes. All the best to you as
thank
well,
you.
Bobby. And really grateful for you to have interested in the role of NSO Thailand. All the best to you as well. Bye-bye
thank
for
thank
now,
so
Bobby.
Much. Thank you. Bye-bye.
Next time. Thank you.
Yeah.